Well, hello there, people of the interwebs. I am High Overseer Tyler. No, we're doing, here we are doing an E3 conversation about our games, or the games we would like to play, or the games we are looking
for. We're basically just gonna fucking run down everything that happened at E3 and, just sort of discuss what we're excited for and what we find was pretty shitty about the whole thing. Go from press conference to press conference in chronological order.
Spell chronological.
Chronos.
It is chronological.
Chronos.
I said spell chronological.
How about you spell these nuts? Okay.
You don't have.
Fucking hell. Okay, fine. The first press conference we're starting off with is EA's press conference. EA's was kind of boring, to be honest. I don't really like EA's. Other than, like, Titanfall 2 and, like, Battlefield 1, EA's kind of blue ass.
Pretty much.
That's because EA is, like, based on sports.
Yeah. Like... Oh, dude, you want to play this fucking... the fucking guy they had running for, like, the... What was his name? Peter Moore? Like, the
I
fucking...
Don't like Peter Moore.
Yeah, they had him talk about FIFA, Madden, that shit. He has the shittiest job title in the fucking world.
He's been from Sega to Microsoft. What's
his job title?
His fucking job title is Chief Competition Officer. What the fuck does that even mean?
Sponsored by ESL.
Something something Chief EA.
Competition Officer. He specializes in beating the shit out of the competition, which they seem to fail at, so it's cool.
Oh, fuck you, EA. Because no one likes you.
My name is
no
Peter Moore, and I'm a fucking piece of shit.
So, I guess since fucking... Titanfall 2 and Battlefield 1 are the only fucking things that were interesting about EA. What does everyone think about Titanfall 2?
It's finally getting a campaign.
I don't give a fuck. Armin don't give a fuck because he didn't really like the first one. Me and Gareth fucking played the shit out of the first one when it first
Not
launched.
Not that it's a shit game, but the first one is disappointing on how much content that they actually game.
That's what I was saying.
The game ran dry in the first week.
I was sick of it.
Yeah. The problem that they had was just the fact that it's like they didn't have enough content whatsoever in the first game in order to stable or to keep it like.
All the cool shit came like 6 months after when like all the fucking main players
It wasn't even cool
left.
Shit though.
It was more like shit to try and keep you busy, but actually wouldn't keep you busy.
Yeah, seriously. But Titanfall 2 looks pretty interesting. I like how they got like the fucking the Attack on Titan like. What the hell are they, like,
grapple
strap shits? Yeah, just spring from building to building.
Yeah, that's pretty cool. I'm excited for it. It looks good. It looks like a good step.
I like
step.
The campaign. I like the way the campaign's looking.
It looks like a good step in the right direction for them.
Oh, yeah, seriously.
For what they did. And here's hoping it doesn't fucking have issues.
I don't want to get my hopes too high just in case it does suck, but I'm looking forward to it.
It shall be.
And of course, EA's fucking bread and butter of the conference, Battlefield 1. Snoop Dogg smoking a blunt. That's all I need to say about that one. Snoop Dogg. I don't know. The fucking all the celebrities that played the Battlefield 1.
They were terrible at the fucking game.
They were all extremely shitty.
Nathan Fillion should have been there.
All right, now it's time for me to chime in. Watch a YouTube video about a guy who actually got to play with Snoop Dogg and Wiz Khalifa. He said even though they were terrible while they were talking to Snoop Dogg and Wiz Khalifa, they were both telling them to go fight. He said both of them are very good team players. Like, they were shouting out, you know, go to that point. You go get that. I'm going to go this way. He said, yeah, they were terrible, but they're good team players.
But okay, so they're good for, like, shot calling, I guess you could say.
Yeah.
I guess that's what Snoop Dogg was doing when he was walking back and forth in the fucking trench for about a minute.
Probably.
I guess he was, like, trying to spot people, or he was just, like, really high and didn't know what the fuck
Snoop,
he was doing.
That's what I thought. Snoop Dogg yelling commands, go get me another blunt.
Yeah, but I'm excited for Battlefield 1.
Go get my bag of chips.
I've been a Battlefield
he starts fucking
fan.
Hallucinating halfway munches. Through the game. Three guys coming right side, two guys in the trenches, giant talking burrito on my left.
Some random shit. Yeah.
What the fuck? Oh, god damn it. So anyone else have any thoughts on Battlefield 1 other than it looks amazing?
I'm excited and I just have high hopes
for that game. It looks like so much fun.
Sherman,
you haven't said shit. What are your thoughts about Battlefield 1? I don't think anyone knows you're here.
It looked interesting. Wouldn't mind trying it.
Yeah. Oh, you will.
Okay. Aiden, your thoughts on Battlefield 1?
It looks pretty cool. That's all I can see.
It looks good. It looks
definitely good. On my fucking pre-order list alongside Titanfall 2. And to move forward, we are going to be talking about Bethesda's conference. It obviously. What do you mean, boo?
Elder Scrolls Legends.
Oh. Obviously, part of it. Bethesda's couldn't fucking match up to what the hell happened that last year's E3. I mean, if they had announced Elder Scrolls 6, that would have been.
Shut up, Skyrim remake.
Oh, dude, what the fuck are you talking about? Elder Scrolls Legend is obviously going to blow Skyrim out of the water.
Hope a shark blows you out the water.
I hope just someone blows me in general.
Everyone's trying to do card games now. I don't mean to jump the gun, but
they are. Well, they are, but at the same time, it's really stupid. It was really stupid to see. We can get into the other one at Microsoft, but it's like, yeah. It all took from Hearthstone, pretty much.
Shut up, I'm a Yu-Gi-Oh!
The one thing that, like, the whole pre-show thing, like, I didn't really like the two pre-show hosts.
We're talking about the guy changing his shirts.
Yeah, the best part about the pre-show was the fucking dude in the background just constantly doing shit and, like, not bringing attention to it, but just doing it to be fucking hilarious. Like, how that the fucking guy just kept changing shirts every time they cut away.
Dude, you were wearing three shirts under.
No, he brought, like, four shirts. Me and Harmon were watching it, and we were just waiting for it to actually start, and It cut away. He was wearing like a black shirt, and then it cuts back, and he's wearing like a white shirt with WTF on like a Union Jack, and like that was when I first noticed it. But I didn't know, until after the conference ended, that he had like three extra fucking shirts that he brought with him.
That's funny.
But that was probably the highlight of the pre-show. Other than that, the two hosts suck ass. And then obviously the conference itself started off with something that Aiden was pretty excited about: Quake Champions. Express your opinions, because I know you have some on the game.
Yeah, like it's nice having Quake back into the floor. So like the last one I played was Quake 3 on the Dreamcast years and years ago. And what's cool was that console had a keyboard and mouse and whatnot. So that was nice. But yeah, it's nice that it's back, but sadly it's only on PC and I'm not really a PC gamer. But
wait, it's only on PC?
Cool. Yes. For now, it seems.
Oh, I was
interesting.
I could have sworn they said it was coming over consoles.
Nope,
it might later.
But then again, I couldn't really. I don't really care to say. I never played any other Quake games, and I don't know.
But here's
the only thing that
though,
excited me about this one was like the blue hair lady.
But here's the other thing though, Desi. Before they showed the trailer, there was that like PC rebooting.
Oh yeah,
startup
like
with
the,
all those letters.
They
showed.
What the hell is it?
They showed all the id Software games in like file form and whatnot. They showed Doom 1, Doom 2, and it showed the years, the dates they were released in. Then they showed Wolfenstein 3D, The New Order, The Old Blood. Then it said New Colossus, but it didn't show the release date. Then it showed Doom 3, Doom 4, all that. But I think they secretly announced a new Wolfenstein game, New Colossus.
I wonder if they did that on purpose. I guarantee you they did, but.
But who knows?
That's still pretty interesting. I didn't play any of the. Well, I played the first, like the Wolfenstein 3D. I never beat it. I just sort of dabbled in it. Oh, what the fuck? What are you doing here?
That's pretty trippy.
Yeah, that was pretty. That was a interesting thing that you caught later on. I didn't notice that because I didn't notice until you told us
that night, and I was like, oh.
And then obviously, Elder Scrolls Legends, the fucking card game that does not look interesting at all. It's like
But it's. But it's cards. I can play cards on video game consoles now. I don't have to do it with friends.
I don't have to go outside and buy a deck of cards. Oh my god, this is fucking next gen. Why waste $5 on a deck of cards when you could say $80 to play Elder Scrolls Legends? Only worth the goddamn purchase.
Yeah, that shit is really stupid. There's certain card games that'll work, and there's
like
Gwent.
Gwent, yes. I didn't really play Gwent all too much in Witcher 3. I dabbled in it. But Harmon and Gareth were the two
right
fuckers.
My first time playing through Witcher 3, I didn't even give a shit about it. But the second time when I went through, I completely lost my shit in it.
Harmon didn't care about the main story for like 30 hours. His entire 100-hour gameplay is just playing Gwent at the Gwent table.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah.
Gwent tournaments trying and to shit. Beat,
trying to beat the Baron all damn day.
Yeah. And the fourth little thing that happened at the Bethesda's press conference was Skyrim Remastered got announced.
And it pisses me off, but I'm excited.
It was Harman Tyler wanted accepted to see, like, Gaben one of the earlier. They're not Gaben. Fucking,
like Oblivion or Morrowind.
Oh, that was when they announced Skyrim coming to the One. Tyler finally accepted fucking God Howard as his Lord and Savior. Dude, I accepted it back when Fallout 4 was announced.
Because I wasn't a huge Fallout fan. I'm like, yeah, Fallout 3 was great. But, I mean,
I accepted
everyone
back
knows
in Fallout 3.
Fallout 3, yeah, I played. Fallout 4, I do have to get more into it so I can beat it, so I can mod it. All the hell. But, you know, like, Skyrim was, like, my shit. I played it for hours and hours. Sometimes I just rolled around my horse looking at the scenery. I didn't even give a shit about the gameplay. Just looked at it. Never got Shadowmere, though.
I got Shadowmere.
Desi killed him way too much.
I killed Shadowmere, like, 5 times. Like, I every time I killed him, I'd reload the save. I'd kill him, reload the save, but eventually I just said, fuck it, Shadowmere's dead.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but, I'm totally excited for Skyrim Remastered, because maybe make the woman look better this time.
Maybe they won't make him look like just fucking gelatinous blobs of unfuckable bullshit.
You mean men?
Yeah, gelatinous blobs of unfuckable bullshit.
Man.
Exactly.
But one thing that I sort of want to touch on, like, sort of.
Oh, so we're touching now?
Yeah. You want to get touched? You want a diddle?
No.
That's what I thought. But, like, another thing I wanted to touch on was also during the whole slew of announcements at Bethesda, they also talked about the phase 2 of the Fallout 4 DLC, and they also announced that it was the final fucking DLC, which I'm pretty pissed off about, because I love the workshop mode, and I was one of the very few people that actually enjoyed it. But the fact that three of the six DLC for the game was just entirely based around the workshop mode, I think that's fucking stupid.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I paid, like, I think it was $30 for the season pass before the price went up to like 50.
Yeah, I don't get why they upped it to 80 when all the DLCs are shit except for
two
supposed to be big ones, but they're like fairly small still.
Yeah,
kind of crap.
I think they said the reason the price went up is because they think they were going to add even more stuff that they didn't even plan about, but
bitch, you thought
they are.
Bitch, you guessing.
But I'm not too happy about the three of the fucking. I paid $30 before the goddamn price went up, and I still feel jipped. That's fucked up.
Yeah, I didn't buy the season pass.
Any single player like that should have like story DLC in that
sense. Not fucking,
like, in my mind, I, like, feel like Witcher
I don't
did
think
it perfectly.
Witcher's DLC, that was all story, right? That wasn't a fucking,
it was straight,
there wasn't
it was
a DLC that just added Gwent cards.
No, there was two expansions. One was one that just recently Tyler. Came out, the other one, the first one was like 20, the first one was about 10 hours or so, and then the last one was 30 plus. So
yeah, like, I stood beside fucking or Fallout 4 through like thick and thin when everyone's saying, oh, there's not enough content, there's not enough this and that, it's not a fucking long game,
like,
I don't like
game.
The new voice actor, but this is fucking stupid. I do not think there should have
the
that
base,
shit should have
vanilla,
been DLC.
I do think that there
should
be
like little add-ons.
Yeah, there should be more to it.
Yeah, like
sure.
Little updates, but whatever.
Something
like
that's
that. That's enough of that before I get too heated and start throwing my controller. And another the thing that was mentioned at the press conference was Prey. I didn't think this was related to like the main Prey that came out on the 360 a while ago.
It's
because
it is.
They announced that it is.
Since when? Who the
like
fuck is this
full
guy?
On sequel? A full on sequel?
It's not a sequel. It's like it takes place in the same universe, I guess. Or it's basically just like an entire new take on the Prey franchise.
Like,
it's one of
total
those.
Total reboot or something.
Basically,
like that.
Just total reboot.
Because I remember back in 2011, they announced Prey 2.
Yeah, Prey 2.
That got trash.
I was kind of interested in Prey 2. like you were a fucking intergalactic space bounty hunter and shit. Yeah. And that the trailer actually looked pretty sick. But and like, when I bought, it just never came to fruition.
And when I bought the game Rage, when I opened the case, there was a little piece of paper that was showing a cover of Prey 2, and it showed that bounty hunter guy on it and said,
"Can we go
on
Kickstarter
and
fund a Brink 2? Please."
Brink?
No, fuck Brink 2. Just cut straight to Brink 3.
Half-Life
Wasn't
3
there
confirmed.
Already a Brink 2?
No.
Let me look that shit up. Yeah, let me see.
I don't think so.
I don't think so.
No,
Brink.
There wasn't. No.
I could have sworn there was a Brink 2. No, never mind. I'm just silly. But obviously the final bit of the Bethesda press conference was Dishonored 2, and I am so fucking excited for that game.
As soon as they announced it, I bought the deluxe edition or whatever collector's edition.
Yeah, Harmon like as soon as they brought up the little collector's edition for that game where you get the mask, Horrible all mask. That shit, Harmon like immediately took to his wallet and just purchased
credit
the
card
shit out.
My money at the screen.
Yeah.
As
for me, I've never played Dishonored 1 or so, but once I saw the gameplay of Dishonored 2, I'm like, okay, that's pretty cool. And then they said, if you pre-order it now, you can get a copy of Dishonored 1. So like, sold, I'll pre-order.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a win-win for Aiden. He hasn't played the game before, so the sequel looks great, and he gets a taste of it for the first time.
Absolutely.
I played through the first game only once, and that was the Chaos playthrough, so I like killed everything.
I think I played
and
twice.
I'm doing another playthrough for my personal channel. Harmon's doing the same. And after I'm done with my personal playthrough, then I'm going to try and go for the Ghost Run, which I should be able to get done before... When does it come out? November? November 11th?
November something.
Speaking of Ghost Run, that's what I'm doing right now.
Yeah, Tyler's currently going through a Ghost Run. You haven't played you haven't beaten the game before, haven't you?
I have. A Ghost Run, no supernatural abilities or enhancements, just my sword, and killing no one.
Yeah, you're making it a little hard on yourself when doing that. He's
putting that fun stuff into his life.
Exactly.
Yeah.
I have it on easy. I'm probably just going to put it on normal. It is on easy because there is no achievement for doing it on very hard, which I was all willing to do, but there isn't one, which blows. Like a lot.
I think that's...
Okay, so...
That wraps up.
That everything on Dishonored 2? Looks good? Sure. Thoughts?
I jizz.
Sure. Thoughts?
Is he there? Good, GG.
Oh, GG?
GG.
All right, GG.
I like it. What the?
Good conference, Bethesda. Not as good as the last, but you tried. And now on to Microsoft. This one,
This was like.
I'll talk about this after we're done everything. But I really enjoyed the press conference. It wasn't.
Yeah.
Didn't have much cringe, aside from some of Aisha Taylor's jokes. Other than that, Aisha Taylor was fucking great. I love her. She's hilarious.
You know what? You know what I feel like, Microsoft?
Aisha Taylor was at the Microsoft press conference?
Wait, no, I'm thinking of Ubisoft. Fuck.
Yeah, I was going to say. I'm like,
okay, never mind. I'm getting my conferences mixed up. Nothing was cringy about Microsoft's press conference, aside from the Minecraft bit. That seemed so forced to me.
What I feel
like no one likes it. The franchise is dead except for
John Carmack. Everyone included in that little bit for Microsoft were just like trying their best to appease to every 5-year-old in the fucking world by just making the most simple shit.
Mm-hmm.
Poor John Carmack.
Poor bastard.
And Notch is just sitting on his fucking solid gold throne and just being like, "You motherfuckers fucked up."
Yeah, no shit. But I think. Microsoft's conference started off pretty strong with Gears of War 4. I wasn't sold on the game to begin with, but after watching gameplay of it, I am fucking take my money.
I agree. I was
skeptical last year when they announced it, and it was like you got JD and some bitch. I'm not sure who voiced some bitch part, but she sounded familiar.
I think she voiced Tanaka in Halo 5.
Tanaka.
Mm. Yeah, I remember from somewhere else, not there. Mm. I never really played much Halo 5. But yeah, pretty solid way to start off Microsoft's press conference. I enjoyed watching the gameplay.
Oh yeah.
It's kind of sad that when it comes to Microsoft, compare Microsoft press conference to Sony's. It feel like Microsoft like runs out of shit, so they have to announce their updates, even though they are great updates.
I know what you mean. That is kind of like an odd thing.
Well, you but don't have at to the same time, like, they Sony don't really never have... announces their shit. But like I said, they don't have enough content, like Sony yeah. did.
That's my point.
I don't know. I'm looking at this list that I made for everything to talk about for Microsoft. It's pretty.
I mean,
long.
To be fair, there are still games that they didn't even like have at E3 that were a Microsoft brand.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So.
But Microsoft, after talking about Gears of War, they sort of toned it down. Started talking about the some of the indies, like what you call it, that ReCore game. ReCore looks pretty fun. I'll definitely be picking up that game, especially since it's only $50. Yeah. Not a full retail game, but I'm pretty excited about it.
It looks interesting.
I really like the music they picked for the trailer.
That's Desi's like main thing. He don't give a fuck about the games. He just
the gameplay
music,
could be
like,
fine, or it could be total shit. As long as the trailer music is good, I'm all right with it.
Straight liquid shrimp coming out of his ears.
Oh, you don't. Ew! What the fuck?
What?
I was with you, and then you lost me.
Oh, it's a.
But after joke. That, after talking about ReCore, they brought up Inside, which was that pretty interesting looking. What was it? It's made by the same guys who made Limbo, right?
Yeah. Yes. It looks just like a Limbo.
Yeah. It looks fairly interesting. That game's been like in like. Development hell for the longest time, even though it looks
has
like the
it
most...
been in limbo.
Ah, I just broke my fucking legs.
Hey, he pulled the pun.
Cool.
Yeah, for once it wasn't fucking Aiden this time. We dropped the shittiest pun, but
you're the better.
After they played that little slideshow of just all the other indie games to come out that'll be coming out this year, like what the hell was that game called? It was the teacups. And it's like infinite boss fights. What the hell is that game called? Fuck, that's gonna piss me off.
Infinite boss fights.
You don't remember? It's like you don't remember that game? It's like they announced it last year. It was
It's like a dude with a sword.
No. It's teacups. They're fighting teacups.
I have no idea what the fuck you're doing.
I know I sound fucking insane saying this, but I know it's an actual game. I'm looking. Just know that it's a game that'll be coming out soon. It's a co-op. Infinite boss fight, just going from boss fight to boss fight, and you're playing as two teacups and just whooping ass the whole time.
That is fucking weird.
It is fucking weird. That's why I don't think it will be
Gingerbread Warrior.
But they also brought up a couple that others I can't remember. That teacup game was the only one that I could remember. But after that, the weirdest trailer they showed there was We Happy Few. That game looks fucking good. Like I love games that just fuck with your mind. Like that's why I loved BioShock Infinite.
Yeah,
and this game does look very BioShock-esque.
It has that BioShock vibe.
Yeah, it's got that BioShock feel, and it that's what gets me excited about the game, because I haven't got my BioShock fix in an extremely fucking long time. When the hell
I didn't even get to play Infinite because at the time, fucking
your
Xbox
download wouldn't work, right?
Yeah, no downloads worked after a while on the 360, so I couldn't. I never had a chance to play.
Yeah, Tyler missed out on his chance to play.
You'll either love it or hate it.
No, I can try again on my 360 because I'm at my dad's house when I go over there, but it just sucks that it wouldn't really work for me.
Yeah, Gareth said he played Infinite and didn't really enjoy it.
I had no idea what the fuck to think about Infinite when I played it.
Yeah, it's a polarizing game.
It was good. Like it was a good game. Like, don't get me wrong, I'm not gonna say it's terrible. It was just like I had no idea.
I found one of my favorite YouTubers to BioShock Infinite.
Who's that? Who's that YouTuber?
Frankie on PC. Shameless plug. I love you. No, I'm joking. But yeah, great YouTuber. He when it came to the end of BioShock Infinite, he was silent. No words. None.
Okay, well, never mind. And yeah, We Happy Few, very interesting. Looks pretty exciting. It's supposed to be coming out on preview this month. No. End of next month. They said like the 27th or some shit of next month.
Something around there. Yeah.
But I will definitely be picking that up. I'll be playing that on my personal channel. Link in the description. Shameless plug. And after We Happy Few, they brought up the fucking standalone Gwent game that I'm not sure if Harmon was excited about. Harmon, you excited about Gwent?
I'll play it.
I'll have it be taught to me. I'll have Harmon teach it to me through a separate game other than Witcher 3.
Yeah, this time it's just all about the cards and not anything about hunting down Gryffindors or whatever they are.
This is not Harry Potter. Okay.
I played a lot of I played Witcher 3, right? I played it for I burnt myself out on that game way too quick. I never actually beat it, which I'm sort
you got
of
close to the end.
I got fairly close to the end, but I burnt myself out on it and I just couldn't play it anymore without feeling this repetitiveness of it. And I really enjoyed it before I burnt myself out on it, but I just played it way too much that it just wasn't enjoyable after a while.
What you do then is you spice it up by going into Deathmatch.
Yeah, but I want to play the game and have fun instead of play the game and want to rip my testicles off in anger.
Well, I mean, it's not. I don't even find myself getting that angry at it. Like when I'm playing and I'm on New Game Plus Deathmatch, and it's not like I'm getting angry. It's just like you saw it yesterday, or not yesterday, like the day before. Like it's just like that. Those type of situations is a real bitch on it. But
yeah,
those are few. So
they're few and far between. Okay, good to know.
Pretty much like my dick.
You got a tight dick?
That's my dick.
So the answer, my dick.
And after the Gwent thing, they announced Tekken 7, which I could care less about. The one thing that I cared more about was the fucking like Cholo Japanese translator that they had announcing the game, and just like I don't know, that guy was weird.
I had like a Nintendo.
He's just trying to put on a show.
CEO from him.
Like they could have gotten. I don't know if he was actually Japanese. Like I couldn't tell because he didn't take off the glasses. As racist as that sounds, but I honestly couldn't tell if he was Japanese or some other ethnicity. He just looked like a straight up Cholo. Like that's pretty much all I got out of him. The
anyone else got anything to say on the Cholo?
Any
I didn't get to see him. I didn't get to see
Harmon.
Him.
Either Harmon, what are your thoughts on the Cholo?
I never saw the Cholo.
Aiden, your thoughts on the Cholo?
It looked like something you'd see in a demonstration that's like done back in the 90s or something like that.
I
want a churro now.
All right, this is all getting Gareth Hunnamy? Gareth hungry for some cinnamony goodness.
I've only had one churro in my lifetime, and that was at Six Flags, and that was many, many years.
I haven't had almost called it cholos, churros at all.
You haven't eaten a cholo in a while.
No,
the honey nut cholo.
It's been years since I've eaten the cholo, but after the Tekken 7, there was. The announcement for Dead Rising 4, which got leaked before the actual press conference, and I know they were talking about it before in the pre-show too.
It
I don't think
called Dead Rising
do the,
4 when it was leaked.
Yeah, I think it was leaked.
It was like,
but do the pre-show hosts know at all what's going to happen in the press conference? Because they were like speculating over a bunch of shit. I don't think they do.
I really don't know.
Because I remember at one point they brought up they're hoping to see some like Dead Rising shit.
Yeah, yeah it depends on which stream you're watching.
I was watching the micro or just like the straight up Microsoft stream on Twitch.
Oh, no idea then.
But I guess they don't tell like the lower people talking or just like
probably not
streams.
Because they don't want them to just blab about stuff. They want it to be a surprise.
Yeah, true,
and
true.
Whatnot. So.
But Dead Rising 3 looks pretty sick. Fucking Frank is back.
Dead Rising
3. He's a lot less fat in this one. Thank God. I didn't like Fat West.
He takes a lot of selfies.
He takes a lot of selfies.
I don't like I don't know if this will be for sure, but I don't think it's a co-op.
Right away or when you get back?
I don't think it would be either. But then again, Dead Rising 2 didn't look like it would be co-op. But, you know, then you got fucking two Chuck Greens running around, so... You know.
Someone Dick told Harris? Me something about how they're remaking one of the Dead Risings and adding four-player co-op.
Oh my God, if that's a thing, we're definitely doing some videos on that. But after Dead Rising 4, they talked about Scalebound. That game reminds me of Devil May Cry mixed with...
It's Devil May Cry meets Dragon Age.
Exactly.
Like...
And
you got
I I didn't really hear much about it beforehand. They didn't really say much. Yeah,
washing dishes right now. What the fuck?
Who the fuck is taking a piss? Sherm, are you seriously preparing food while we're fucking doing this discussion? Is that Sherm?
I'm pretty sure it's Sherm.
Sherman.
That's funny. Regardless.
Sherm. Sherm.
Whatever.
I thought I muted the mic when I got out of my room.
What the hell did you do? Did you take a piss or some shit? What did you do?
It's a secret.
All right, but Scalebound looks pretty interesting. I like the fast-paced combat. I'm currently running through Devil May Cry 4 because I never really played the Devil May Cry games, so I'm starting with 4. And
Devil May Cry 4 is amazing. DMC.
Sherm was the Devil May Cry expert. He beat Devil May Cry 4 and DMC. They're pretty much just the ones that came to the one, basically.
Never got to play any Devil May Cry games. Always
around here, that counts as an expert, because no one else has ever played them or beaten them.
I've played them, I just haven't beat them.
Yeah.
DMC was fun, though. I enjoyed DMC.
DMC was pretty fun.
I didn't defeat Devil May Cry 4. I only defeated DMC.
Gotcha. Well, I'm currently running through DMC 4, or Devil May Cry 4, and I had a lot of fun with it. I like the fast-paced combat. And
It's a good hack and slash.
Yeah, it's a good hack and slash. I also really like the music in that game, and the music carries
sponsored
over.
Sponsored by Beats by Dre.
Fucking Scalebound, sponsored by Beats. And I'm pretty excited about it.
Put a beat on the screen. Like a literal beat.
Just vegetables. Eat your fruit and veg, kids.
Yeah.
But Scalebound, interesting game. Excited to play it.
How many have words on that, don't you?
Any words on Scalebound?
Nah.
Just excited to have like the 4-player dungeon type esque multiplayer.
It does look interesting. The only thing that I was wondering is it like another. You guys know how Halo. You guys done Halo 4 co-op at all?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay, you remember how like Halo 4 co-op, even though like you had your own character in Halo multiplayer, you were never able to use that character. So like in Halo 4, everyone was fucking a Master Chief. And like when it came to Halo Reach, you all had your own individual Spartans. When they were showing the trailer, it was just like different versions of the same guys, but were like different colors. So I was just like, eh.
But I also like how he. I'm not sure if that was just for the. This was just for the presentation. But I also like how he commented on like the four extra guys, or like the extra three guys, because he looked at the giant dragon and then looked at his friends. He's like, there's four of us and one of you. You don't stand a chance. I wonder if that carries over to the actual game where he comments on how many people are in the session or that was just for the presentation.
Yeah, who knows?
That's cool.
Yeah.
You have to wait and see.
Either way, game looks pretty interesting.
It looks good.
Oh, and Desi?
Yeah.
Side note, Final Fantasy 15, the guy playing it, it was hilariously bad that he sucked at it.
Yeah, the guy in the Final Fantasy 15 portion of it, the person who played the game absolutely blew ass. Like he never touched a controller in his life.
Yeah, and then the guy standing beside him was like, "Apologies," and then at the end he's like, "Good job, good job."
He has no thumbs, man.
Oh, poor bastard.
That's fucked up. What if he actually didn't have thumbs in their prosthetic, asshole?
Then why the fuck would they put him on a stage to fucking show off a goddamn
Maybe they felt
game.
Bad and he was like,
what conference?
Get that streamer that can play fucking CSGO with his face and his fucking feet.
Okay, he was... What? What streamer is that? What the fuck did you...
I don't know. Which
conference was it that they had this guy get on the stage, this Asian guy who could barely speak any English at all, and they had him introduce a game. I forgot what conference
Tekken?
It was.
Are you talking about?
It might
Kojima?
Have been Tekken. No, it wasn't Kojima. This guy had. Oh, I think he had.
Error.
Kojima.
How you do? My name is Kojima.
I'm back.
No, but
this is highly offensive.
This is really.
I'm offended.
Hey, no, they're.
Check your fucking privilege.
No, one of my buddies works for like a telephone company, and he says he once heard an Asian lady speak in that like stereotypical tone, like not pronouncing L's, like "oh hello." I was like, "Whoa, that's amazing!" He was like, "Is my dream come true? Did I finally meet one of you?" I'm like, "Oh my god, that's bad."
God, I know he didn't, but I.
Oh, it's funny. Oh, what we didn't walk the party.
I got it. Don't worry about it.
Funny. Here, I got it. No.
After Scalebound, there was I think it was Final Fantasy 15, which we touched on. And after Final Fantasy 15, there was what? Sea of Thieves. Yeah. Sea of Thieves. They announced that last year. Not many people remembered it from last year, but I definitely do because
I did. I have
the thalassophobia, which is like the fear of large bodies of water. But
you
I
have
feel
fear
like
of life.
Yeah, you know what? Yeah, I do.
You guys continue on. I probably won't be that long. Hopefully.
Okay. All right.
But
it's dying, so I'm charging it.
All right. But Sea of Thieves, that game was announced last year, and it looked pretty interesting. It's basically just like a large open world multiplayer. It's basically like GTA Online with pirates. It looks
and
pretty
islands.
Interesting. And islands.
It looks entertaining.
And I have pretty big fear of large bodies of water, thalassophobia as it's called. And I feel like playing this game will help me break that because it just looks like so much fun and so cartoonized. Or is that it? It looks so cartoonish. Yeah, that's what it is.
Cartoonish.
Wait, what is it? Explain 22. Your fear. Is it being in the water or just staring at water? Like, how do you take showers?
It's the fear of large bodies of water. Like, I could sit in a fucking bathtub and be just, like, entirely fine. I could sit in a pool entirely fine, but, like, put me in an ocean or in the
lake and
starts
crying.
Is it because it's dark down
there? No, I'm okay with a lake. Like, a lake's just fine. Basically, just, like,
so basically
anywhere near the ocean, I'm fucking terrified.
Is it because it's dark down there?
It is.
Just... Yeah, basically.
But it is,
I just don't like not knowing what the fuck is underneath me.
Well,
I'll admit... From me being in the water and going snorkeling like that and not knowing what's that deep is kind of, I can understand. Because I saw a fucking, like, manta ray.
Actually, a whale.
And shit, like, underneath me.
The only thing that would make me never go into the water is, like, when you see the people who record themselves swimming out and, like, this one guy swam, like, next to a whale. And then caught on camera. I'd never do some shit like that. I could never.
I'd swim next to a whale. As long as I don't get near its mouth, I'm happy.
Oh, they won't beat you anyway.
Finding Nemo taught me that whales have fucked up teeth. They're like little strands of hair. Very strong strands of hair.
So they can filter out the water so they can actually get food.
Yeah. But as long as they don't, like, in my mind, like, as long as you don't go near their mouth, I think you're okay. Like, if you're, like, beside their, like, torso, I think you're fine. Don't get smacked by their fucking fin.
The size difference startles me alone. Like, honestly, speaking of fears, I always had this irrational fear. It's not a name for it, but like going to like a zoo.
The clubs?
In what? No.
Oh, you're fucking
going to a zoo and like, you know, they got like, oh, like this was a polar bear. So look at this glass. I was always scared to touch the glass because I felt like I'd just like go right through it. I think Harry Potter did that to me. Like, remember when they had the snake and he made the glass invisible and, like, his, like, fucking cousin pushed and he fucking fell right in? Mm-hmm. Fuck you, Harry Potter.
Way to go, Potter.
Yeah.
But yeah, Sea of Thieves. Once that game comes out, expect some videos from us here because I know...
Possibly.
I don't know if that's a promise. But I know I'm definitely picking up that game.
I don't know.
I don't know about these guys. Harmon, you picking up Sea of Thieves? You excited about the game?
I don't even know what the fuck it is. So right now, I don't give two shits.
All right, the very indifferent Harmon. After Sea of Thieves, there was... What the fuck was it? State of Decay 2!
All I ask is...
I want multiplayer.
As long as it doesn't have as many fucking bugs and shit as the first one, you're fine.
I get very lucky with that shit. Like, I have bad luck in general when just playing games, but when in terms of bugs, I rarely ever find bugs. Other than, like, tiny shit.
The amount of bugs that are there.
I didn't encounter very much. So I don't really have anything to say on just in terms of State of Decay 1 bugs. I fairly enjoyed the game.
Game's great. Like, the game's incredible. Like, it's the one game, if you're, like, a zombie fan, like, a zombie survival type fan, or I guess I could say like a Walking Dead, like that's the closest you're ever gonna get to like something like that. just because the way it's made.
Exactly.
And it was good.
Armin, do you talk to Syndicate too?
Only if it's co-op.
Yep. And they have announced that it is co-op.
I agree.
So you
co-op, I will play it. If not, I don't care because, well, State of Decay 1, I didn't really like just running around by myself. It was very tedious and boring.
So yeah. They announced that it is co-op?
Yes, it's co-op.
I'm jizz. Cool.
You are jizz.
I'm jizz.
I am the embodiment of jizz.
It's pulling my finger.
But after ZDK, there was Halo Wars 2.
Halo Wars 2.
That is a...
I don't give a fuck.
I don't, honestly. I know Halo's a great series, but Halo Wars 2...
I never series, played Halo Wars in general. Is a waste of time.
I
have
played
no
the fuck out of Halo Wars 1, but that was like when I was... How fucking old was I? I want to say it was 11 or 12 when I first played Halo Wars 1. And I really enjoyed the game because, well, I was a fucking stupid kid. I enjoyed anything that was Halo-related because, you know, little Halo fanboy. But I tried to play the Halo Wars 2 beta, and I just couldn't get into it. I don't know why. I just couldn't get into the Halo Wars 2, so I probably won't be picking that up. Aiden, your thoughts on Halo Wars 2? Because I know you're pretty excited about the game.
Yeah, well, I don't know if I'll pick it up or not, but I just want to know what happens to the Spirit of Fire. That's about it.
We don't know who that is.
Just the ship. The ship in the damn campaign.
I don't play the damn campaign.
Didn't play it? Sucked.
And the cutscenes are cool too, you know?
Yeah. Well, I like the
cutscenes for Halo Wars 1, they were pretty fucking kick-ass. I'll give them that. They did a pretty nice job doing the cutscenes.
And those same people are back doing Halo Wars 2.
Exactly.
Yeah.
But one thing that I wasn't happy about is that they're changing the voice actors for Captain Cutter and whatnot.
That's something that I absolutely hate the video games do. Like, I hate when they replace voice actors.
There are certain ones that you just need to keep.
Exactly.
Like, the original voice of Captain Cutter, that fit. This one, I don't know. It sounds too younger than what Captain Cutter really is.
That's like when they made Splinter Cell Blacklist and they made...
Yeah, Blacklist.
Yeah, it made him look younger and more like slim fit, and like in Conviction he looked like gritty.
Slim fit with that cute ass.
Hey. Yeah.
And to finish off the Microsoft press conference, they announced the Xbox One S and the Project Scorpio.
Project Scorpio.
Oh, not getting, I don't know.
Not getting either of those. Nope.
I want to get the Xbox One S, but there's really no reason to with Scorpio.
Okay, so the Scorpio,
I'm getting
next, Scorpio
it's
next year
it's
at holiday.
The Scorpio.
It would be nicer
like
for you though,
Xbox, because
your setup, like that smaller console, would be better for you.
Not
I
only
say the
that,
best,
but it's small and cute.
The best way to buy it is if you're the Xbox One you're using right now breaks or so. You know,
my, you know what? I think I'm.
Don't
I'm
tell me how to spend
it.
My money.
Just because my Xbox has been fucked up for a while. Like, any time I play a game, it fucking squeaks. Like, I don't know why. It just sits there, it runs squeaks. Perfectly fine, but it squeaks. And it's fucking annoying.
My Xbox
like
is Harman's a magician.
Headset.
And oh, for example, I never bought the 360 Slim because I still use the original 360 I have. Still works, and it's 10 years old.
Yeah, I think I only bought an Xbox when the Slim was out, and that was when Reach was released. But I'm not sure. I would like to buy the Slim, but it's like, at the same time, if there's not a drastic change like what Scorpio was
going to
be...
I'm buying a Slim. Enough said.
Then
I will be
I'm
buying
not sure
one
if
too.
It's worth it. To be
I'll
fair,
buy
though,
when mine breaks.
Like, I wouldn't buy it if it was like the same price as a
300
one,
bucks.
But it's only $300. Like, that's a decent price for what it is.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
That's like, if anything, I can just say, like, I would buy it.
Plus, it
the
comes
price
with a
2
terabyte hard drive. That's exactly. More than 500 gigabytes.
That got filled up. That because
buying a
2
terabyte hard drive itself is like $100 or so.
Yeah, yeah. So, like, to be fair, you're not, like, doing much different.
That console is, like, dirt cheap and just better.
And it has 4K support. Yes. It's basically like the. It's for the. I feel like this console sort of for like the casual gamer, because it's like you want to buy a Blu-ray player and a, I don't know,
what,
fucking
Blu-ray
player.
What, did you just call me, you pleb?
I called you a pleb, little bitch. But, like, you want to buy a Blu-ray player. Blu-ray player, how much is a fucking Blu-ray player? Like, what, $200? You pay an extra fucking $100, and you get a Blu-ray player, and you can play fucking games. It's a win-win. And you can watch it in 4K, and you got 200 terabytes.
Well, you need a 4K TV slash monitor.
But you get 2 terabytes of storage space. Win-win. Good console. Project Scorpio. Don't know much about it. I don't know. I'm not sure if I'm buying
that. Project Scorpio
that.
Is the VR runner of the machinery.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's being developed.
Upgrading.
I
want to
see how the console actually
It's pretty much
looks.
A mini PC.
It's a PC, just not with the PC case.
Exactly.
It's supposed like what
People
they're basically
saying,
like from what I got from the press.
A lot of things that
it,
I've read is the Scorpio is the console to end console.
Yeah,
wars.
Like that's what I was getting too. Like I was getting it at the fact like that thing is supposed to be the most powerful console like out there in existence,
ever.
So, like, they're trying
the
to knock it out the fucking park.
Eat ass.
The Neo is a lost cause.
Never forget. But the what's next? Oh, Ubisoft's press conference. Ubisoft.
And that's the one I didn't watch.
Sort of short and sweet. Not very much happened at Ubisoft's other than the aforementioned Aisha Taylor and her, you know, her jokes that were pretty hit or miss. There was no, like, in between. But it started off pretty strong with Ghost Recon Wildlands. It's one of those. Oh, shit. It's one of those games where. It was one of those things where they had actors play out the situation that would happen in the game, and it's like they're
using, like a Division type thing.
Yeah, they're like talking like how no one would ever talk about, like in an actual fucking scenario like that. Like what Sea of Thieves did. Fucking balls. But what Sea of Thieves did, fuck. But what they did was they got actual people, like actual gamers, to come in and play the game. And then they recorded their reactions, and that was pretty cool. This, I don't know, I don't really want to get too hyped about
Ghost Recon Wildlands, because, you know, it looks good, it looks fun, but Ubisoft has a tendency to downgrade their games, like, before they come out. Like, they've done it so many times before, I just don't believe what happens at the press conference. Like, I want to wait a little while before I actually make a decision to purchase or not.
For me, I've never had that problem with Ubisoft games. Like the famous one is like the Watch Dogs, whole Watch Dogs problem, right?
Yeah.
Like that, like I never saw, like I saw gameplay of Watch Dogs when it first came out.
It also happened with the Division. Like they showed so much shit for the Division that wasn't in the game. Like I'll probably have some footage of it playing in the background of this, but it's pretty fucking drastic. Like the difference.
Jurassic.
I said Jurassic. What the fuck ever that word. It's a pretty damn big difference between what they showed at E3.
I've just never
the
seen
actual
that
final
difference.
Product
like the
was.
Way that people are all like going all crazy about it. Like I never saw it. Like it looked just fine to me. There was no issue.
Yeah. So
it's like why? And to me, it's like I'm a fan of Ghost Recon. I've liked it since the first couple. Like fucking which one? Grah. Like Grah 2 and all those. And so I just like Ghost Recon in general. I'll play it regardless.
You're trying to make a console Arma.
Nah.
But yeah, that was Ghost Recon Wildlands. Fucking the gameplay looks amazing.
Pick it up,
but
spring.
So, mm-hmm. Yeah, next spring.
February.
But I don't want to get my hopes too high for the game. Like I said, just in case they downgrade it, water the fuck down. But man. Whatever. Wildlands looking pretty great as it is at the moment. Take it as you wish if you believe it's going to get downgraded as well. But after Wildlands, they talked about South Park, the Fractured Butthole. They brought the thing that I like about that the South Park thing is they actually brought like Matt and Trey Parker out to talk about the game. And one of the things that they did was they were, like, talking to... I'm not sure who it was. It was either Aisha Taylor or just some fucking Randy who worked on the game as well. But they were talking about how they wanted to get deep inside their butthole in terms of just how good the game is going to be, basically. And they just went on about getting inside this guy's asshole for a little longer than they should have. And that just sort of made me feel all awkward and made me question my sexuality. But, yeah.
I am...
South Park looks pretty interesting.
Dom Funny. Curry. What, just the, like what the... this motherfucker got to say to me?
What? Any thoughts on South Park? Mm-hmm. Fractured Butthole?
Man, I can't wait to get my fractured butthole.
That fucking guy at the EB Games. When we were in this guy just said that to us, like...
He said it like good six seven times. It's like, would you shut up? Say fractured so butthole much. One more time and I'll give you one.
Oh, Jesus. Aiden, just, what are your thoughts so on South Park?
As I said, I didn't watch the Ubisoft conference yet, so I can't really see.
All I gotta know is this. if you want to play that, play the first one. If you, that's not gonna sell you, then the other one's not going to.
Yeah, but the first play one's the Stick of Truth
hilarious
first.
And great.
Yeah,
so good.
Tyler, thoughts on South Park?
Thoughts on South Park? I have never gotten a chance to play the first one. I would like.
You will
to.
In a second.
Yeah, but it's, I don't know, the name speaks for itself in my mind.
It just proves how fucking absurd the game is. I like, in the trailer, like, when they were talking about the gameplay and shit, I like how they brought up, like, how your character's actually gonna have a backstory, but in the typical South Park fashion, your character's backstory is one night, he was in bed, enjoying himself, you know, about ready to go night-night, but he hears a strange noise coming from his parents' room. He goes to check it out, and he finds his mom and dad fucking, and that's what prompts him to become a superhero. And then they have to explain to Cartman that every parent has sex to produce a baby.
It was the funniest joke of E3, for sure.
Absolutely.
What they did.
I also like the little Marvel shit they had going on, like they talk about the phases of movies, and how, like, after... half of the people walked out. Fucking Stan or Kyle, I can't remember who it was, but some kid said, "I didn't think Civil War was supposed to happen until Phase 3." I just like the little in jokes they have for that. But I'm looking forward to it. I liked Stick of Truth, so this one is straight up my fractured butthole.
Harmon's playing that right now.
I am.
Yeah, Harmon's currently running through Stick of Truth for the first time. And after after the fractured butthole, there was For Honor, which I didn't really see much about. Gareth is very excited about that game.
I didn't get to see anything about it.
The game looks pretty fucking amazing, to say the least. Like, I really like the way that game looks. I like the premise, too.
Mm-hmm.
It's like you got three armies,
Eternal
samurai,
warfare.
Vikings, and who else was it? Who was the third?
So, Vikings, and Knights.
Knights. Yeah, and they're all fighting over water. And I also like the trailer they had for that. Like, it was the three of them fighting for water. And then slowly over time, the armies grew more and more. And it went from these three people to this massive onslaught of just fucking people fighting for it. Until eventually they stop and then realize that war is useless. But some bitch... I don't remember who the fuck her name is, but, like, she wants the war to keep going on, so she has, she mind controls or does some shit where she has one opposing soldier shoot the Viking, and then that just puts him into an all-out bloodlust, and then the war continues. And then the game looks fucking interesting as hell.
It looks good.
And I'll definitely be picking that up.
They showed campaign this year, and the campaign looks cool. I like the way
fighting looks.
I kind of got like a slight Dynasty Warriors.
Yeah.
Thought
just
of
like
that.
Maybe not Dynasty Warriors. It's not that big, but I could see.
No, it's not. It's
see
nowhere
with, like,
near
feeling.
What Dynasty Warriors is, but I'm.
Yeah.
It's just.
I could see like I could see like the vibe. Yeah. But anyone else's thoughts on For Honor, Tyler?
I really get to see much on that one, I will definitely be checking it out after this conversation. But yeah.
What?
For Honor. Thanks for paying attention to the conversation, by the way. You're a real asset to this fucking group.
I'm busy playing XCOM. Can we talk about the multiplayer of it, though? The one-on-one fighting?
Yes. I'm excited.
I will fight you and wreck you type of thing where
it's like it's really cool.
Shut up. If you're one of those people that you're two guys are fighting, you come in and hit the opposing person in the back of the head, you're a piece of shit, and that's unfair.
Yes.
Well said.
I agree. I do like that they make it like they make it seems like they make every single multiplayer fight like that, like a personal type fight. It's like it's just you two. And they like they zoom in the camera and shit to like to make you think it's like it's literally just you. Well, when there's like this entire around. Fucking war fight happening around you, yeah. Which I like. Yes. And it just looks nice. I'm excited. So what's after For Honor?
Watch Dogs 2. Huh? Let's go to that. Watch Dogs
2. No. We still have two other things. Well, we still have one other thing to talk about, or two other things to talk about before we get to Watch Dogs 2. The second thing, the aforementioned thing, being, oh, fuck, I died. Hey,
how about you listen here, motherfucker? Watch Dogs 2 is next, okay?
What do you mean? What do you mean?
We just talked about For Honor. I said Red Link's intro. They didn't know, so I was like, all right, whatever.
No. Okay, here, let me talk about the Red Link's intro then. So Red Link's had this fucking weird ass intro where they had these two really fucking out of shape bald guys come out to this cringy ass fucking rap music wearing full on red leopard print suits, fucking like acting all cool and shit with fucking this rap music playing in the background as they walk down to talk about what the hell was it? Trials of the Blood Dragon. Yeah, like they walk down talking about that game. And that was just the whole fucking dookie fest of just retardation, to say the least. It was.
I didn't see.
They were
it.
Fat. They at one point the guy was like walking down with his hands all out and shit. Then he like rubbed the back of some dude's head. The dude did not look very happy about having his head touched.
That was.
But yeah, that's pretty much all I wanted to talk about for Red Link's intro. But Trials of Blood Dragon. I thought it was a Far Cry game. Didn't know it was a Trials game, even though it should have been fairly obvious from the start. Probably not even picking it up.
It's a Trials game.
Yeah, it's a Trials game.
Yeah, it's on the store right now.
Yeah,
I know it is. I just never knew it was Trials. I assumed I kept thinking it was Far Cry. This is
yeah, same
time.
Here.
No,
but yeah, that's Trials of the Trials of the Blood Dragon, as well as Red Link's is very awkward intro, and I just can't get the thought of that fat man's belly out of my head. Anyways. Watch Dogs 2. Holy fuck. So good.
I don't know.
I'm looking forward to the game. Like, it looks fucking good.
I'm looking forward to it. I'm just not paying attention to actual gameplay. Like, I haven't, like, watched in-depth
from
gameplay.
The,
I saw the one gameplay clip. That's
can
about
the,
it.
Can the multiplayer be better?
Please?
They talked
and
about,
not
they
have
talked
my
about
save
how,
fuck up?
How it, they talked how, yeah, you got fucked over by that. But they talked about how it would be the multiplayer would be seamless with the co-op, with the single player. Like you could have someone or one of your friends just running around, and you could see them running around, but you could still be doing a mission, if that makes any sense. So like you'd be doing a mission, and then you'd have your friend.
And wouldn't you be able to have your friend fuck everything up?
Oh wait, no. Then... I don't think that's it. I think. In free roam, just straight up free roam, you can see your friends running around. But once you start a mission, that's turned off.
Ah, that makes
but
sense.
It looks.
So what you're saying, it's like an MMO with friends. But as soon as you start doing something like the main story or blah blah blah, whatever the hell you wanted to go do, then they just disappear.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Poof, it,
gone.
What the fuck other game did that?
You can go on like a crew, like hunting mission of collectibles and shit.
Yeah, Destiny does that. When you're in like the Cosmodrome on Earth, you can see a bunch of people doing their own shit. Once you get to that point where you're supposed to be on your own, those people are gone.
Yeah,
so Destiny kind of fade out of into the Matrix.
But I really like the way the new character's looking. Like, what was his name? Marcus? Yeah. Marcus, whatever the fuck?
Marcus Phoenix.
No.
Black.
He's black. Not the
no. No, it's funny. I like how the
really
black
like
guy
doing.
Gets more athletic.
Yeah, like one thing I really like what doing is that they wanted Marcus to be entirely different to Aiden. So he's in a lot more of an exciting world, which is San Francisco. He's a lot more agile, so his parkour looks a lot more badass, and he's just a lot more of an interesting character so far. Like Aiden was interesting.
He has more of a personality.
Yeah, he was interesting, but he didn't have a personality. Marcus has personality, and all the friends that he has in the world have personality, and it's just a more
like that
lively
one
world.
Dude with the cyber mechanic face. That, like when he was Yeah, I didn't get to see his name. He was like, they were in the car together, and he was like happy. His like mask was winking at him. I was like, what the fuck?
Yeah,
that was
like
pretty cool.
Yeah, what you call it? Watch Dogs 2 looks absolutely great, and I'm excited to play that game once it launches and whatever the fuck. It comes out this year, right?
November.
Yeah,
November.
Okay, so I'll definitely be playing that game. Harmon, you playing the game?
Yes.
Garrett.
Yeah.
Tyler, you'll probably be playing it because you're linked with Gareth. Aiden, your thoughts on Watch Dogs 2?
I haven't seen it yet. I've
he doesn't play anything but Halo and Doom.
True.
Next topic.
Come on there. All right. So next, let's just skip this one and get right into the Sony. So Sony started off with God of War. Disappointing Sun Simulator 2016. It's
I don't
funny
know what
how
the
you
hell
go
to
from
think
Kratos,
about it.
The fucking killer of just gods and titans and all this, and then he produces this whiny little bitch. Like, I feel like the daughter that he killed would have been more of a badass than this kid.
Probably.
You can't call him a whiny little bitch. I mean, it's like
a whiny
thing
little
about...
bitch. He shot Kratos in the fucking
That doesn't mean he's a whiny little bitch. He's a bitch with no talent. Definitely one of those.
He's a whiny
but I mean,
bitch.
Think about it. Like then, back then, like the Spartans, like, oh, I gotta train my son. Like, oh, Dad, I don't want to kill the wolf today. Like, bitch, you better get the fuck.
Massa, no.
Massa, no. Fucking kick him in the ass. Get the fuck out there. Kill the goddamn. Okay, yeah. Okay, no. When I think about it, he was whiny because he didn't want to kill the deer. Yeah, he's whiny. Mm-hmm. I take that.
Yeah, he's a whiny little bitch. But God of War. I don't really have much opinions about the game series. I didn't really play much of it. That's Gareth's department because he's played through 3.
I haven't played through
and I think
like, all
of them, right?
But I played through like yes. 2, and I love.
Hey,
them.
I beat 3 in like 20 minutes.
You did not.
I did 2.
You picked my save like an ass.
I still beat
to
it.
Fucking go and beat Zeus to a pulp.
Yeah, God of War. I probably won't be picking it up. I didn't really care for the God of War series.
They
changed Kratos' voice actor, so no.
That I didn't know. He doesn't sound that bad to me, but I still think original.
Well, he's older.
Regardless.
I don't think they keep the same voice.
I don't give a fuck. I just want an angry
regardless,
motherfucker. Not this.
Has to be aged a little,
bitch.
Regardless, I'm excited for it. It looks good. I have no idea where the fuck they're going with it though, because of just the setting. Like I expected him to be in like some sort of prequel, almost similar to Ascension. But then they come out, and he ain't no on Mount Olympus with the Greek fucking castles and shit. He's in the goddamn woods looking like Ellie from Last of Us. I don't know.
I think they're living
what they're
near
gonna
Mount
do.
Olympus, honestly.
Like the ending part with like the dragon and shit. Like they had. Because
he's
Olympus
raising
back,
a son to just kill all the gods.
But they're all dead.
See, I did not play all through the God of Wars to know
exactly,
that.
Exactly, all
thank
the gods
you.
Are dead. So it makes you wonder what are they gonna use now? Because he got his revenge. And did all that. But I don't remember exactly what the hell they said. They said something about like the time period about it, like where it would be taking place in some sort of.
I wasn't really paying attention. I didn't really care. I don't, like I said, I don't really care for the God of War series, so I didn't really. I just sort of toned out during that part.
Yeah. But it looks good. It looks like it would be a decent title.
That's Gareth's apartment. I won't be picking it up. Harmon, you picking it up?
I don't have to.
Oh.
He will
right.
by default.
Tyler, you don't even. Wait, you have a PS4, but would you pick up God of War?
Oh, actually, I am thinking about getting when I get my job, when I go to school, I am gonna pick it up.
All right,
definitely.
Aiden, no one gives a fuck about your opinion because you have none. Days Gone.
There's Harmon's words.
This
oh
game,
my God. That is like the revolutionary,
so fucking
game
good.
That I've always wanted.
I agree.
Like, oh my God, the. I feel like they had a beefed up PS4 or something running, so they had all of that.
No
fucking,
shit.
All of
was
those
it the Neo?
It might have been. Might have been. But all those Neo? Zombies on screen at one time was just fucking insanity. Like, I
got a
I don't
War
think
Z feel.
They died a lot easier than I thought they would. But it was still really fucking interesting.
It makes sense for them to die that easy, just because if you think
yeah,
about
the,
it,
the
like,
fucking
you have that
numbers.
Amount of enemy. Yeah, you can't be going for headshots on every single one of them.
Exactly.
That ain't gonna work.
But I love just the him like the fucking. They just flop over. It's like like you said, it's like World War Z. They just there's just so many of them, but they just flop over once they're dead.
If they start building walls to jump over Trump's wall to keep Mexico down,
But yeah, Days Gone. I like the biker theme of it. It looks pretty interesting. Mm-hmm. Harmon and Gareth thought it was a Sons of Anarchy game.
We thought it was like a biker type club. Like,
I didn't think it was Sons of Anarchy, but I was just
no, lit. Not Sons of Anarchy, like, but like that sense of like it's like a.
I did not think like it was going to be a zombie game.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. I didn't either.
The story looks pretty interesting. The gameplay looks fucking amazing. The character, he looks rather. I don't know. I don't know how to talk about him.
Something?
They haven't shown enough.
Yeah, really? Yeah, but the game looks good. I'll probably be picking it up. Armin's going to be picking it up, I know. Gareth, you picking it up?
Yeah, I plan to.
Tyler?
Looks good.
If you tend to be interested, would you pick it up?
I need to see more on it. I didn't get to see enough. I saw like the intro part to it, but I never saw gameplay like everyone else has. So I need see that first.
Yeah. But yeah, that's Days Gone. Interesting title. Excited to play it. And after Days Gone, Horizon Zero Dawn. This was a game that Gareth talked about before, but I didn't know much about it. So when I seen it, I was kind of caught off guard.
They showed different gameplay this year, which was fine. But in my mind, I think the first gameplay that they showed was better just because of the enemy, like the main enemy that they showed at the end.
I didn't see the previous one.
If you see that one, like if anybody knows about it, it's like you're in prehistoric times, but all the like dinosaurs are robotic and weird looking.
Prehistoric futuristic.
Yeah, it's really kind of an interesting concept, and so like everything
a vegan's world.
But it's all like mechanical and like mechy type shit, and
with prehistoric stuff.
Yeah, it's interesting, but like the first gameplay that they showed, you had to fight like literally like the T-Rex of that game, and that thing was huge. It was big, and so this one they showed like what.
I want to say like 7 minutes of gameplay.
Yeah, the only new thing that I kind of saw from that was some newer like abilities, like an imp type grenade that she had, or some shit like an imp arrow, something like that, and then the conversation wheel thing, which I don't know why the fuck that's even in there really, because from what I heard, it doesn't do any, like it doesn't impact anything much. So it's like, why is it there?
Someone to fuck off.
Yeah, that's pretty much its one use, but it looks good. I'd say it's made by the same people who made Killzone, right?
Yeah,
yeah, because it looks just like Shadowfall, Killzone Shadowfall, like in the sense of scenery, it looks exactly like it. So I'm excited. It looks good. Looks like something.
I'm not too sure how I feel about the game. I want to see more on it before I cement the decision on whether I want to see or buy it or not, but. If anything, I don't think I'll be picking up this game. It just doesn't pique my interest.
Looks Armin, decent enough.
Your thoughts? Buy or pass?
IGN.
IGN, all right. Tyler, buy or pass?
Yeah, I would.
Buy.
Well, I would play it.
Armin is thinking.
As long as the gameplay is more than just running around killing dinosaurs, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah. Aiden?
Undecided.
I don't even know why.
It'll probably have more than that, I would think.
And after Horizon Zero Dawn, probably one of the most intriguing titles they showed, Detroit. That game looks confusing as fuck.
Well, if you've never played a game like Heavy Rain,
I played Heavy Rain. I got the platinum trophy for Heavy Rain. Yeah, I played the fuck out of Heavy Rain.
John!
Sean!
Keep talking. I'll be right back.
Jason! But Detroit looks, I don't know, it looks interesting. I said that a lot in this video, but yeah, it looks interesting.
Interesting.
I like the vast amount of choices that you can make, and how many choices you have to fuck up, and how many choices you have to succeed. Like, it looks...
Everyone's gameplay of it's going to be completely different.
It's going to be you watch a Let's Play of, like, one person, like, I don't know, fucking PewDiePie. It's going to be completely different to Markiplier. Or, you know, keeping in the realm of this little group, you watch my Let's Play of it, it's going to be completely different to Harmon's. So, yeah, it's going to be a very different experience for everyone.
Dude, I'm fucking
hungry. It's definitely going to be like Heavy Rain in the sense that no one's going to have the same experience the first time through. But I'm pretty excited about it. I'm definitely going to be picking it up because I loved Heavy Rain. I enjoyed Beyond Two Souls, but didn't really like it as much as I did Heavy Rain. But this one looks amazing. I'm excited for it. And I just want to play it now.
That's pretty good.
Armin, Detroit. Your thoughts on the... I mean, Gareth, your thoughts on Detroit?
My thoughts on Detroit? It looks...
Detroit is ghetto.
I enjoyed Heavy Rain. I liked Beyond Two Souls, even though most people, I don't think, did.
Yeah.
Beyond Two Souls was a very interesting take on that type of game. And basically, like, that type of game, like, I enjoy. Ellen Page is amazing. She's a legend.
She was nude in that game. Like, actual bobs.
It wasn't her body, they said.
I don't care, bobs. I don't care. It's Ellen. It's Ellen Page's face on a naked body. I'll take it.
But yeah, like any game like that, I enjoy. So I'll try it. I'm not sure exactly how it would go, just because of how it's like set up.
Could they make another game that's like Until Dawn? Just obviously a different.
I would love another Until Dawn.
That would be
another horror game like that.
I would love that because Until Dawn is like the best horror game I played in the past like 3 years.
I just really wish I didn't fuck up as much as I did in my playthrough.
Yeah, I fucked up pretty bad.
You killed fucking...
Everybody but two people.
Yeah.
But yeah, after Detroit, it's definitely a buy for me. I'm not sure about these guys. Buy?
I'd buy.
It's a possibility.
And after Detroit, they revealed... Resident Evil 7 or Biohazard 7, whatever you want to call it.
I'm pissed about the demo of that game.
The demo was just fine. I don't give a fuck that it's not none of the shit that is going to be in the actual game. It's basically like PT if Silent Hills actually happened. Like I know this one's going to happen because I don't actually. I just really hope it happens.
Made by Konami.
Because Konami's not going to fuck up and just I don't. Fuck Konami, man.
Konami's just a dickhead company now.
Hashtag
man.
Fuck Konami. Really, Ed? Nothing?
Nope.
Wait, what? I kind of spaced out there.
I said hashtag fuck Konami. I didn't say anything.
Oh, you bastard.
All the times he complained about hashtags, they were false. He was able to flip that into like the drop of a hat. He's a liar.
Lying son of a bitch. Yeah, I've always liked the Resident Evil series. I haven't played all of them. I've only played the first Resident Evil, second Resident Evil, 4, 5, and that's about it. I didn't play any of the ones on the Wii. I didn't play any other. I didn't play
sucked.
Zero. Oh, it's
six. Terrible.
Six was. It started off as a so bad it's good, but after playing it for a while, it was so bad it's bad. Like it was one of those transitions where you think it's gonna get better, but it inclines up and then goes straight the fuck down.
Yeah,
like it what made it so bad? Game. What made it so bad?
It wasn't a Resident Evil game.
It wasn't Resident Evil. Like if they had slapped any other title on that game, it would have done fine. But the fact that they put Resident Evil in the title just ruined it.
Yeah. Speaking of,
they made Chris Redfield a fucking alcoholic. That's fucked up. You don't mess with my boy Chris. And to fucking top it off, question, they gave me Justin Bieber as a goddamn like companion for that shit. Oh,
is everything still running good?
Everything's just fine.
Okay,
but
cool.
Asking.
Anyways. Yeah, Resident Evil 7 definitely a buy for me. I enjoyed the trailer. I know Harmon did because he did a playthrough on his channel. Go check it out if you really want that. Link in the description. Yep.
You sounded neglectant to even say that.
I'm obligated. But yeah, Harmon, you picking it up?
When I see more.
Yeah.
I don't want Resident Evil 6 to happen all over again to me. I played that so excited, put it in, and then I cried on my couch underneath my SpongeBob blanket.
SpongeBob with a bottle of lotion. Okay, after Resident Evil 7... they showed off the PSVR shit. It was that fucking Batman VR, Arkham VR.
I don't really care for the VR.
Final Fantasy VR. Shit that I don't give a fuck about.
Until there's stuff that's out for it in the
until
next
it's
like,
stable
5, 10 years.
And like completely amazing, then I won't even touch it. Yeah. And it's so damn expensive right now. We're
no
thinking
shit,
about even getting it.
$300
will,
fucking
like, burn
for
your wallet.
Headset. I cry when I see the price. I cry. But after PSVR, there was Call of Duty Infinite Warfare. The one game that everyone fucking hates. I'm indifferent about
my eyes and sit up.
I do not see the reasoning to why people hate it so much. Like, it looks just fine.
Let's break this trailer down, or the gameplay down real quick. Let's be scientists. That shit was fucking dope. What are you talking about? That spaceship shit, it wasn't even bad. It was actually very exciting to watch, and like fucking grappling on somebody, you can either stick it, I guess it's random every time, you can stick a grenade to them or fucking like snap their neck. That shit was fucking dope. It was nothing. Shut up. All right, Titanfall stole it from somewhere else, so shut your damn mouth. All right, it's nothing wrong with it. This whole Battlefield over Call of Duty, shut the fuck up. All right,
it's over. Shit.
It's stupid.
Like, it's such stupid both fucking argument. I'm excited. And if I keep hearing about it, I'm excited for both.
Honestly.
Yeah, they're both just like they both look good. Like they.
Honestly, I am expecting a lot of complaints about the gameplay trailer. Why? The reuse of a gun sound.
When I went to go download the gameplay for the background of this video, the fucking trailer had 63,000 dislikes and 20,000 likes. Like, yeah, people really don't want this game to happen.
Right. Well, like I said, remember when people were complaining about the death animation that was replayed?
Yeah.
There's a gun sound that's replayed in the gun you see the guy use in the beginning.
There's a fucking gun sound replayed in Black Ops 3.
I know, and no one got on that. I feel like they're just getting on Infinity Ward on purpose.
They are.
And the gun model of the gun you're using looks, because the back of it had that yellow pullback. It looked like another gun. I can't put my name on it.
It looks either like an M27 or a Honey Badger.
It also looked like the gun you're given at the beginning of Destiny. Well, the one you're first given.
Like, it just looks... It looks just fine. There's no... I wouldn't think it would have any issues. Like...
I'm indifferent about it for now. I want to see more things on it before I cement my stance on it. But I'm indifferent about the new Call of Duty.
Yeah, I got no problem with it. It looks fine. It'll probably be just fine. If it fucks up, then, like, whatever. It has a problem. So be it. Every single fucking turn into a ghost. Always have an issue. Exactly. Like, if it turns into a ghost, it turns into a ghost. Whatever.
It's not like a Battlefield never had an issue on launch day anyways.
Oh, exactly. Fuck you, yeah,
Battlefield is
shit.
Infamous for fucking launch day problems.
They are infamous for having problems, man.
Like, honestly, if I knew there weren't going to be any backlash, I talked about an idea of, like, what if, like, it was, like, Call of Duty did, like, their whole, like, capture the flag thing, but, like, with spaceships. Like, imagine that. Like, you got to capture this whole ship. Boom. Right there. It's yours. You got to, all that. Yours. You got to keep it. Or the other team's going to take it. That would be dope. Or,
they
like...
They kind of did that in Battlefield, but not ships in the sky.
Or it's, like, it's kind of like a... One team has all the ships, and it's like a rush sort of thing. You destroy one ship, you keep pushing them back. Yeah, but I mean, of course, you know the fanboys out there. Oh, they stole it from Battlefield. Blah, 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 blah. Shut the fuck up. I don't give a shit.
Exactly. Yeah. Well, there's our thought on
that's
that.
That's the Call of Duty Infinite Warfare gameplay. Harmon Gareth, Tyler, Harmon, what's your stance on it?
Getting it.
I'll probably play it. I will get it.
But yeah, Gareth, Harmon, and Tyler are cemented.
And they
on
are gonna put zombies
game
in there, which is I hope
they
keep
they
true
are
to
making
their word
their new,
on that.
Their own zombies as well. So
I'm indifferent about the game. Aiden doesn't give a fuck because Aiden doesn't really have much of an opinion on most of this stuff unless it's Doom or Halo Wars. But yeah.
No, that's not it, but just I don't care for Call of Duty in general.
Yeah. That's fine.
Yeah.
It's good. Sherman will probably play it.
And after the Doot Doots. There was they announced the Crash remix, which I've only played Crash Wrath of Vortex.
Yeah.
And I'd like to go. That was the first game I ever played. The first game I played was Crash Wrath of Vortex. I loved it. I played the shit out of it. That was my childhood. And I want to go back and play these ones, but I'll just wait for the remakes to come out. So, Crash remix, I'm excited because I never really got to play
excited.
It. The only
you
two
heard
Crash
me
games
scream
I played
when
was
I saw it.
Crash, Bandicoot, Wrath of Vortex, and Crash Tag Team Racing. Those are the only two Crash games I played. Yeah. Anyone else have opinions on Crash?
Never played
fucking
Crash.
Dope.
My the one Crash I played was the fucking Easter egg in Uncharted 4. That is it.
No, I am very excited about this remake. I used to love Crash. It was like this. I think the Wrath of Cortex, my favorite level, used to be when you they put Crash in this ball. He was in the jungle. He had to go around like this little like.
Oh yeah, yeah, I remember that mission.
Favorite level.
That shit was favorite level. Bomb.
It was like I used to just play that one because like, I could get just. You play that one correctly, you're getting like 4 lives by the end of it. So.
Yeah.
One thing I never understood: why peaches?
Don't ask. Don't ask.
Because that's what bandicoots eat. I don't know.
No one knows.
I've never owned a bandicoot. I've never actually seen a real life bandicoot, so I wouldn't know. But yeah, that's the Crash remakes. I am excited. Harmon is excited. Tyler is excited. Gareth is indifferent. Now let's move on to the last topic of this video, which is Kojima's new game, Death Stranding. What?
Nothing.
What did you say?
Norman Reed is holding a fetus.
Norman Reed is holding the fetus.
Kojima's game, I don't even know. I have no idea.
One of the most interesting fucking
we can't really
trailers
talk
I've ever seen in a long time.
They showed a trailer and now nobody knows what the hell it is.
Yeah, nobody.
Exactly. There was fucking 5 people floating in the end. Norman Reedus had a weird scar. He was naked for some reason. There was a fetus that then turned into an invisible oil fetus. There was a bunch of dead fish.
I told you, he was
there
the
was
one
ocean.
That was pregnant.
There was Kojima. There was more Norman Reedus, and there was more Norman fetus.
There's Norman Reedus' ass, too.
There was Norman Reedus' ass. And all the girls were excited.
All for you, ladies. All for you.
Yeah.
It's I don't know. I feel like Kojima signed Reedus on for PT or Silent Hills, and then once that got canned, he was fucking hell bent on making a game with Norman Reedus. So we kept him around and just waited for it to so he could start up his new company, and then this came to fruition. This weird son of a bitch. Yeah, that's Death Stranding. I'm not too sure how to feel about it. I want to see actual gameplay before I make a decision on whether to buy it.
I got no idea what the fuck.
Yeah,
to think
it's
about
just
that
the
game.
Confusing
it just looks
mess
so
of the game.
Out there and weird. I have no clue.
It's really strange.
Yeah, but now let's go to the conclusion of this video. Everyone here, who do you think won this press conference? Out of the 5 conferences that we talked about, Ubisoft, EA, Bethesda, Microsoft, and Sony, who do you think won?
Sony.
Sony absolutely won. They just announced so many good games. I mean, obviously, Microsoft is a close second. I fucking love my Xbox One. I play a lot more than PS4. But I, in my opinion, PlayStation exclusives are way better than Microsoft. So,
yeah.
In my
opinion,
with all
Overdrive.
Shut the fuck up. With all the new exclusives they announced at this year's E3, I think Sony absolutely won this little competition.
Doesn't Sony win every E3?
Well,
so
they're just
say.
Yeah, but this year they absolutely they
I don't
blew
think they did
Xbox
last year
out of the goddamn water.
But this year
I didn't
did.
Think I don't think I remember last year.
All I remembered was Shenmue 3. That's all I cared for.
Last year was like Xbox was all about
was
the game.
Like Free Willy 3
last year. And then this year it was the other way around, and PlayStation did very well with it.
Like I said, yeah. I just feel like Xbox runs out of time or runs out of things to talk about, so they gotta throw their updates
I kind of
in
agree.
Somewhere. Like, yeah, we care about the updates, but
like they didn't have like no like GTA or Red Dead or something like that,
which they people were very disappointed about. Like no.
There was also rumors of a BioShock collection, but that never happened.
That was pretty disappointing. I cried.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, that's pretty much it. Anyone have any closing thoughts on the EA as a whole? E3 as a whole?
It was good E3.
Rip Wallet?
Rip Wallet.
Yeah, no shit.
Yeah, pretty
I have so many games just
Wallet
like
is gonna
pinned
be
to my fucking Xbox that
fucked.
I want to download or want to buy. Like everything
it's
here
just,
right
just,
now is
basically
fucking
the next, like from like August to December.
I'm gonna be broke. Like I'm gonna go bankrupt.
There's too much shit. There's way too much.
I need to find a new
job. Why can't you just spread it out a bit more?
Yeah, seriously.
It's because it holiday like season equals presents, which equals cha-ching.
Money. Lots and lots of money.
Dough.
All right. Anyone else? Closing thoughts?
Please.
It's good.
For the love of God. Stop the Call of Duty and Battlefield debate.
Yes.
They're total different games, but still don't care about Call of Duty. So that's all I can say.
They just need to stop. Everybody needs to just shut the fuck up about it and play them before you start giving opinions.
It's no different to Marvel and DC Comics. That'll never end.
Exactly. But yeah.
Marvel's so much better.
That was this old school Marvel for me, that is. Discussion. We hope you enjoyed our endless rambling for this entire thing.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's about it. Thanks for watching. My name is Bangman. These are all the rest of these fuckholes.
Stay classy.
See you in the next
video. Keep it breathing. Yeah. My heart is dry. I don't laugh and I don't cry. I don't think about you all the time. Well, when I do, I wonder why. No more tears. My heart is dry. I don't laugh and I don't cry. I don't